Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, dear brothers and sisters, with the second lesson of Tajweed rules. And today, inshallah, I will explain the rules of Noon Sakin and Tanween. And I will say the first one, which is Al Idhar. Then, inshallah, we'll follow up with the next rules in the coming weeks, inshallah. What I mean by Noon Sakin and Tanween, when the Noon comes in the middle of the word or in the end of the word with Sukoon Haraka over the Noon. You know that we have more than one Haraka in Arabic. We have the Fatha, what you call it in Urdu Zabar. We have the Kasra, what you call it Zair. We have the Dhamma, what you call it Beish. And we have the Sukoon, which is a circle or half circle over the letter, means this letter is not moving fatha or kasra or dhamma, just a silent. Like for example, the ayah in the Surah Al-Fatiha, ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim. Look at the dal. Under dal we have the kasra, over the noon we have the fatha, over the ha we have the sukoon. Over the meem in al-mustaqim we have the dhamma, and so on. Tanween, also same of the noon sakin, when we have two dhamma or two fatha or two kasra over or under any letter in the sentences, like the following: وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. You see, kufuwan, we have two fatha over the alif. وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ. We have two kasra under the qaf. فِي جِيدِهَا حَبْلٌ مِّن مَسَدْ. We have two dhamma over the lam. This is an example of the tanween. For noon sakin and tanween, we have four rules. Number one, Al-Idhar. Absolutely, those rules based on the next letters in the words or sentences. The first one, Al-Idhar or Idhar. The letters of Al-Idhar in the Noon and Tanween rules: Hamza, Ha, Ayn, Ha, Ghain, and Kha. What is the meaning of Idhar? Idhar means to read the Noon or the Tanween as is, with no delay or stress or ghunna, what we call it, the nasal sound. If those six letters, Al-Hamza wal-Ha, Al-Ayn wal-Ha, Al-Ghayn wal-Kha, one of them came after the Noon or the Tanween, Noon Sakin or Tanween, absolutely, we do nothing on the Noon. We do nothing in those letters. You read it as is, no delay, no stress, no any other action. With the examples will be easy, inshallah. وَمِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدْ. Here we have Tanween Kasr at the end of حَاسِدٍ. Then the next one we have the Hamza. Hamza from the حروف الإظهار. So we do idhar here, means you recite the tanween with no delay, no ghunna, no nasal sound and anything like that. No stress, just keep going. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. Tanween fatha with the hamza. مَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُ مَالُهُ وَمَا كَسَبْ. عَنْهُ, we have noon sakin and we have the letter ha, so it's idhar. الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. As you see here, we have the letter Noon, Min, then the letter Kha, Kha from حروف الإظهار. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. The Noon in أَنْعَمْتَ, then the letter عَيْن. This is إظهار, so we do nothing, just read it as is, without any stress or ghunna or delay. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ. We have tanween dham, in the letter Ayn. So it's Idhar. وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ كُلَّمَا رُزِقُوا مِنْهَا مِنْ ثَمَرَةٍ. Here we have الأنهار, نون plus ها, منها also نون plus ها. So those are examples how you practice the إظهار with noon sakin and tanween. More inshallah information coming with the episode number 3. May Allah bless all of you and benefit all of us inshallah, and give us the hidayah and the best knowledge to practice our deen inshallah in the high standard way. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.